alternative conceptions refer to ideas that people have which are inconsistent with scientifically acceptable ideas. The term misconception is also sometimes used. Terms such as alternative conceptions and misconceptions are sometimes used synonymously, but some authors given them different meanings. Unfortunately, within the literature, there is a range of uses for these and other related terms such as conceptual framework, intuitive theory, etc. The terms alternative conceptions and alternative conceptual frameworks derive from an approach to thinking about student learning known as personal constructivism. Alternative conceptions, sometimes called as misconceptions, can really impede learning for several reasons. First, students generally are unaware that the knowledge they have is wrong. Moreover, misconceptions can be very entrenched in student thinking. In addition, students interpret new experiences through this erroneous understanding, thereby interfering with being able to correctly grasp new information. Also, alternative conceptions tend to be very resistant to instruction because learning entails replacing or radically reorganizing student knowledge. Hence, conceptual change has to occur for learning to happen. This puts teachers in the very challenging position of needing to bring about significant conceptual change in student knowledge. Generally, ordinary forms of instruction such as lectures, labs, discovery learning, or simply reading texts are not very successful at overcoming students' misconceptions. For all these reasons, misconceptions can be hot nuts for teachers to crack. However, several instructional strategies have proven to be effective in achieving conceptual change and helping students leave their alternative conceptions behind and learn correct concepts or theories. Do's. Instructional strategies that can lead to change in students' alternative conceptions and to learning of new concepts and theories. Ask students to write down their pre-existing conceptions of the material being covered. This allows you to overtly assess their preconceptions and provides them with an opportunity to see how far their understanding has come after learning the new concepts. Consider whether student preconceptions could potentially be beneficial to their learning process. It is possible that preconceived notions about material, even if not entirely accurate, could provide a base from which to build knowledge of new concepts. Present new concepts or theories that you are teaching in such a way that students see as plausible, high quality, intelligible, and generative. Use model-based reasoning, which helps students construct new representations that vary from their intuitive theories. Use diverse instruction, wherein you present a few examples that challenging multiple assumptions rather than the large number of examples that challenge just one assumption. Help students become aware of their own alternative conceptions. Don'ts. Do not rely solely on lectures. Do not rely solely on labs or hands-on activities. Do not rely solely on demonstrations. Do not rely solely on having students simply reading the text. do not rely solely on a singular perspective when there are multiple ways to interpret material. Electronic media, broadcast or storage media that take advantage of electronic technology. They may include television, radio, internet, fax, CD-ROMs, DVD, and any other medium that requires electricity or digital encoding of information. The term electronic media is often used in contrast with print media. Media has become an integral part of our daily life. Electronic media also plays a dominant role in the process of education. It has a huge impact in shaping the lives of our future generation. You all know electronic media like internet is used to download information, play games, and retrieve information and so forth. It is also widely used for distance education. Media has both positive and negative effects. However, positive effects outweigh the negative effects. Electronic media and education. With the emergence of internet as the global media, education has evolved to a large extent. Distance education programs are conducted through online media, which has proved to be quite beneficial to people who seldom have the opportunity to have interactive classes. In the earlier days, distance education was conducted with the use of educational CD, books, and paper documents, which were dispatched through post. But today, online modules are made available to the students through educational websites. Through online media, distance education is conducted with online educational classes where the student and the teacher can learn and teach respectively through internet facilities from any part of the world. Today, quality online courses are offered to the students at an affordable price rate. Practical advantages. A major advantage to use multimedia sources in the classroom is the ability to bring in images, sounds, and videos without leaving the room. Computer programs and internet sites can also give students experiences that might ordinarily be unsafe, such as views from scaling mountains in a geography lesson or a dissection of a rare animal. Additionally, using a projector or individual computers gives students the opportunity to view information or materials up close. Educational advantages. Students who learn from materials containing both text and graphics produced 55% to 121% more accurate solution to problems, according to David Taylor at the University of Maryland. The use of images along with words diminishes the overwhelming nature of text and helps the student to manage the cognitive load, which increases retention. Specifically, graphics are found to support retention because important elements are focused on the via placement, layout, and color. Activation of prior knowledge is engaged quickly with visual analogy, and mental models are created easily as diagrams can enhance understanding of how a concept works. Additionally, learning is made easier because simulations allow students to visualize real-life situations, and motivation is increased as students are able to see the relevance of skills. Practical disadvantages. Multimedia lessons or components of lessons delivered via video or image require computers, projectors, and other electronic devices depending upon the subject and the amount of original material a teacher creates. The expense associated with the quality projectors or computers for every student can be quite high, and the amount of images and videos in a lesson can slow down the delivery and the pace of the class as a result. Student access to computers at home may also cause problems, and varying quality of student electronic devices can create inequity in projects and presentations. Educational disadvantages. When designing a multimedia learning experience, the role of a teacher shifts from instructor to facilitator. If a lesson allows students to complete learning at their own pace as they move through stages of learning, classroom management becomes increasingly difficult. This is particularly true if students work in groups to view the multimedia sources or share computers. Additionally, students who are not as proficient with technology may have to spend more time learning computer skills to access information than focusing on course materials. Experiential learning. Experiential learning is the process of learning through experience and is more specifically defined as learning through reflection on doing. Hands-on learning is a form of an experiential learning but does not necessarily involve students' reflection on their product. Experiential learning is the distinct from rote or didactic learning in which the learner plays a comparatively passive role. It is related to but not synonymous with other forms of active learning such as action learning, adventure learning, free choice learning, cooperative learning, and service learning. Teamwork. Teamwork is a dynamic process involving two or more healthcare professionals with complementary background and skills, sharing common health goals and exercising concrete physical and mental effort in assessing, planning, or evaluating patient care. Having followed a volatile trend in the past century, the societal diffusion and application of teamwork has shown a sharp increase since the late 1970s. Drawbacks and benefits. Some teams, especially those not composed according to the aforementioned standards, may perform poorly, that is, work less effectively than should be expected according to their members' combined capacities. This is partly due to the efforts such as social loafing. In addition to that, group decision making seems to be less efficient and creativity can be lower in groups than a combination of individual efforts may be. Problem solving. A single brain confounds different ideas of each other. Each team member has a responsibility to contribute equally and offer their unique perspective on a problem to arrive at the best possible solution. Teamwork can lead to better decision, products or services. The quality of teamwork may be effective by analyzing following six components of collaboration among team members. They are communication, coordination, balance of member contributions, mutual support, effort, and cohesion. In one study, teamwork quality as measured in this manner correlated with the team performance in the area of effectiveness and efficiency. Healthy competition. Healthy competition in groups can be used to motivate individuals and help the team excel. Developing relationships. A team that continues to work together will eventually develop an increased level of bonding. This can help people avoid unnecessary conflicts since they have become well acquainted with each other through teamwork. Team members' rating of their satisfaction with the team is correlated with the level of teamwork process present. Everyone has unique qualities. Every team member can offer their unique knowledge and ability to help improve other team members. Through teamwork, the sharing of these qualities will allow team members to be more productive in the future. In healthcare, teamwork is associated with increased patient safety. Importance of teamwork. For students to achieve a comprehensive, well-rounded education, integrated teamwork on several fronts is vital. Teamwork is necessary between students and teachers, and among parents and educators. The more teamwork fundamentals exhibited, the more opportunity exists for students to learn the vital skills of compromise and collaboration. Teachers and paraprofessionals. Many classroom environments employ the use of paraprofessionals, teaching assistants, student teachers, and even parent volunteers to help with fundamental classroom exercises. This assistant frees up the time for the team leader or the lead teacher to focus on skills development and classroom management. To be effective, good communication and teamwork between the adult is vital to ensure that students are getting the time, attention, and levels of instruction required. Typically, each adult in the classroom is tasked with carrying out specific duties and responsibilities in a collaborative manner. Co-teaching. In many academic settings, the teachers in the different departments team up to ensure a continuity of instruction for students. A fifth grade science teacher focused on scientific measurements and calculations might collaborate with the fifth grade maths teacher who teaches volumes and measurements. As a team, the teachers create a crossover educational experience in which students of both educators have the opportunity to see how statistically information can be used in different disciplines. Teachers and parents. Parents play a vital role in a student's education, particularly during the formative years. When the teachers and parents act as a team, it can reinforce positive behaviors and learning skills developed in the classroom and practiced at home. When students see educators and parental figures working together, they learn to value education and get academic and behavioral support both inside and outside the classroom. Parent-teacher teams that communicate well can share information about the student and help devise ways to individualize learning approaches to best meet students' needs. Student collaboration. Team or group work in a classroom teaches students fundamental skills associated with working as a collective unit toward a common goal. This type of teamwork introduces a variety of skills that will be valuable for students later in their workforce, such as communication, compromise, and collective effort. In any type of group work, students must agree about who will handle various components of a project and work in tandem using one another's strength to accomplish assigned tasks. This teaches time management, resource allocation, and communication skills. Project method. According to State University, the project method of teaching is an educational enterprise in which children solve a particular problem over a period of days or weeks. It offers teachers a way to develop in-depth thinking in young children while engaging their hearts and minds. Importance of project-based learning. Project-based learning helps students to develop their skills for living in a knowledge-based, highly technological society. Project-based learning and technology use bring a new relevance to the learning at hand. Project-based learning lends itself to authentic assessment. Project-based learning promotes lifelong learning. Project-based learning accommodates students with varying learning styles and differences. Research supports project-based learning. Coming to the merits of project method. By making use of this method, following advantages are gained by a teacher and also the students. First is, as a student, students get proper freedom to execute the project in accordance with their interests and abilities, because of which they get their psychological needs satisfied to considerable extent. Next, this method is not only subject-centered, but due importance is being provided to the students also. Students are permitted to choose projects on their own, as a result of which they make use of their abilities to maximum possible extent. Through this method, students are provided with various opportunities by which they can satisfy their interests and desires. Next comes, habit of critical thinking gets developed among the students through this method. Not only get this, an urge to make use of scientific methods to solve various problems also developed among the students through this method. Next is, with this method, students get the ample chances in which they can develop coordination among their body and mind. Through this method, teacher can lead a well-balanced development of the students. Demerits of project method. This method has certain limitations, which are as follows. First, this method takes a lot of time to plan and execute a single project. As the time available with the teacher is limited in the schools, thus they find it difficult to make use of this method in their classes. It is not possible to design different projects for different topics, and it is also not possible to cover all the topics or content in a single project. Thus, this method becomes impracticable in nature. For proper execution of a project, large number of financial resources are required, which seems difficult to arrange in our nation, as we have to face shortage of resources in every sphere of life. Such method can only be successful if the teacher is highly knowledgeable, alert, and exceptionally gifted. The responsibility of teacher becomes multifolded, as right from providing situations and opportunities for the selection of projection, he provides the students with all the provisions by which they can execute the projects successfully. When to use? As this method has various serious limitations, because of which it is not possible to use this method exclusively for science teaching. Teacher feels the need to make use of other methods of teaching also. Along with this method, in other words, this method can be used as a supplement for the proper utilization of usual classroom teaching, which is understood by any good teaching method. Some experts consider this method not as a method of teaching, but as a method of making use of knowledge and acquired skills. While keeping in this mind such points, it can be said that this method is suitable for elementary classes and should be used where the number of students in the class are less. Through this method, nature study can be best taught to the students. Integrated approach. Integrated learning incorporates multiple subjects which are usually taught separately in an interdisciplinary method of teaching. The goal is to help the students remain engaged and draw from multiple sets of skills, experiences, and sources to aid and accelerate the learning process. Learning through an integrated studies approach is enhanced when students are actively engaged in meaningful and relative topics. Learners construct and produce knowledge by solving problems, conducting inquiry, engaging in reflection, and building a repertoire of effective strategies. Integrated studies help students to become lifelong learners and allow efficient coverage and delivery of curriculum in terms of expertise, resources, and time. What is integrated teaching? An integrated approach allows learners to explore, gather, process, refine, and present information about topics they want to investigate without the constraints imposed by traditional subject barriers. An integrated approach allows students to engage in purposeful, relevant learning. Integrated learning encourages students to see the interconnectedness and interrelationships between the curriculum areas. Rather than focusing on learning in isolated curriculum areas, an integrated program is based on skill development around a particular theme that is relevant to the children in the class. Why an integrated language unit? Children learn language is a vast range of context, both social and educational. Language is used to communicate ideas throughout every curricular area using at least one of the three strands, oral, written, or verbal. How will integrated teaching and learning impact on any SB? It is nothing but non-English speaking background students. Integrated teaching and learning provides many benefits for NASB children. We'll see it now. Children are grouped according to learning needs or cooperative learning. Effective integrated programs provide opportunities for experience-based learning. Students are able to use their prior experiences to construct learning. A range of shared experiences scaffold NASB children into learning, giving every child in the class knowledge to base their learning on. Because integrated units are child-centered, they provide opportunities for cross-culture sharing. Opportunities for children to display competence are given rather than relying on a written test or an oral test. Coming to the conclusion, so far we had seen electronic media and some of the uses of electronic media, then experiential learning and their merits and demerits of experiential learning. Then the next topic we had seen is teamwork, and in the teamwork we had seen the merits and demerits. Then we had seen a topic of project method. In the project method, how it is utilized to the students we had seen. Last but not least, the last thing we had seen is integrated approach. I hope you all understand the topic. Thank you, students.